Could this be the best way to protect people who are at risk from a threat like this? The volcanic emergency in the Philippines has forced thousands of people to leave their homes in a hurry. In Ecuador, people who live near an active volcano are being shown what to do if disaster strikes. The idea is to spend more money on preparing for the worst.
Normally we arrive after the disaster stroke already in a community and we have to react. No, we are trying to anticipate.
People fixing the world.
This is volcanic ash and it can devastate entire communities. That's what happened to Lydia, who's a farmer in Ecuador, close to the Cotopaxi volcano. An ash cloud blew into her village in 2015.
El día se convirtió en la noche y a toda la comunidad era tapado y era también que corríamos de un lado al otro lado sin saber a dónde ir o qué hacer, porque era la primera vez que nos estaba pasando eso y nadie nos había dicho cómo era la erupción. Entonces ese día fue como un terror vivir esa fecha.
Lydia didn't know how to keep her family and animals safe. She panicked and sold her cows to the first buyer she could find for a fraction of what they were worth. This man hopes that in the future he can stop people panicking. His phone is tracking activity inside the volcano, and the data on it is fed through a monitoring station.
We can see if there's earthquakes, if there's vibration. Also, we have other instruments installed to see if there's some gas coming out or if there's ground deformation, and that will allow us to give an early warning.
Thanks to Ben, the volcano alarm that warns villagers when Cotopaxi is stirring can now be rung up to 72 hours in advance, so everyone can evacuate calmly. The Red Cross uses the extra time to hand out survival kits. And evacuees are also given cash to tide them over. And they're given help to build shelters to protect their animals from ash. This event was just a practice. Lydia says it's taught her what to do if it happens again.
Con las capacitaciones que nos han dado, sabemos cómo evacuarnos, proteger hasta nuestros animales, nuestros hijos, y poder salir todos para no vender a los animalitos.
The Red Cross says getting people ready for a future emergency can save lives and money, but it gets less attention and fewer donations than a real crisis.
Of course, it's always more difficult if it's not in the media. To get people and really people donate money for it, I think at the moment it's still more difficult.
It could be years before Cotopaxi stirs again. But if it does, at least local people will feel better prepared.